So I would like to welcome to the Way Back Country Jamboree today, just in time for Mother's Day 2022, one of the best loved television mothers of all time. For over 9 seasons, she played the lovable yet always wise Olivia Walton on the hit television program, The Waltons, as well as many other television and movie roles. However, today she is celebrating 50 golden years of The Waltons with us here on the Way Back Country Jamboree. Please welcome to the show today, Miss Michael Learned.
Hi, thank you so much for having me.
Well, it's a pleasure to be talking to you.
You know, I lived in Toronto for many years. I raised my youngest son was born there.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, so I feel part of me is Canadian.
Well, that's great, great. Well, we're proud to have you. So let's go back to when and where you were born. I understand you were born in Washington.
Washington, D.C., yes.
Yes.
I don't remember it, but they tell me I was.
Yes. When did you know you were wanting to become an actress?
Well, when I was 12, I went to an art school in England, and ballet. I wanted to be a ballet dancer, like young girls do. My boys want to be firemen, and girls want to be ballerinas. Anyway, one day one of the dance teachers came up to me and said, you know, you're not really a very good dancer. Why don't you specialize in drama?
Okay.
So I did. I became a special drama student. Yeah.
Yes, I see. And if I may ask, you always had a masculine name. How did that come about, the Michael name?
Well, my pet answer is, I think my parents were having a couple of martinis too many. that may be true, actually.
Yes.
But, we all have unusual names. I'm from a family of 6 girls and one boy.
Okay.
From a later marriage on my father's part.
Yes.
And I think they're all, Gretel is my next sister, and Susan is the one with the normal name.
Okay.
And Sabra and Zorit and Philippa. So all the names are a little unusual.
I see.
But, mine is the most.
I see. Yes.
I don't know why they did it. They thought it would be funny or fun or something. It's annoying, frankly.
I see.
I've learned to live with it.
Yeah, exactly. I hear you. Now, when you were 33, you were cast as the mother on television program, The Waltons.
Right.
How did that come about?
I was. Well, my husband, Peter Donat, who is a Canadian actor, actually born in Nova Scotia, and we were going through a divorce, and I had 3 teenage kids to support, and he wasn't, you know, we're actors, so when you do theater, you do what you love, but you're not paid a whole bunch of money. So I knew I had to come down to L.A. and learn the freeways, because L.A. was a terrifying place for me in those days. So San Francisco is a small town, but L.A. is sprawling, not really suburban, it's not really city, it doesn't quite know what it is.
I see.
So I came down to just kind of meet casting people and try to find my way, you know, learn my way around a little bit in case an audition would come up or something. And I walked into this room and there were all these guys sitting at a big long table, and they said, would you like to test for the part of the mother on the Waltons? And I didn't even know what they were talking about, but I said, sure.
I see.
And then I read that they were looking for a woman in her 40s with long red hair.
Yes.
And I was 32 and I had very short blonde hair, so I didn't think I stood a chance, but I'm one of the lucky ones. You know, sometimes luck is just where God's hand on your shoulder, that's the way I put it.
Exactly.
God's hand was on my shoulder.
That's for sure.
So it was very much a blessing in my life.
Yeah, and all these 50 years later, you're still television's great mother.
Well, thank you.
What?
That's the writing. I appreciate that. They were good writers on the show. The only trouble we have on the show was, you know, I would say to Earl, because he idealized family. I mean,
yes.
He had to, really, because they were all still alive. How could he write bad things about his family?
Mm-hmm.
But I said, you know, people sometimes love you more for your human frailties than they do for your perfection.
Exactly.
So every now and then you just have to make Olivia make a mistake or hold the wrong child or do, you know.
Yes.
Just not be so perfect. So that was a struggle. That was my only struggle on that show, were the hours, which were long, and, you know, the tendency to make Olivia into some kind of an angel rather than a very human mother who was overstressed at times, and, you know, just human.
Exactly, I hear you. And what does that role mean to you all these years later?
It means just a about everything. I met the second family. I love all these kids who are now middle-aged adults and have children of their own, but they're like my second family.
Okay.
And they were all at my wedding to John. It was a ceremony where the priest says, who gives this woman to this man? And all my Walton kids stood up, and all my own kids stood up, and they all shouted, we do! So, you know, they really are very much part of my life.
I see. Okay. And two co-stars that I have often wondered about, Ellen Corby and Will Gear. Ellen always seemed to have that attitude or that snart, stricter side to her. Was that in real life too?
She was very close to that character that she played,
yeah.
She was strong, very strong. She could do splits, which I couldn't do even when I was dancing.
Yes.
But she could do splits, and she was a strong-willed, feisty woman.
Yes, that's what I meant, feisty.
Terrific actress, but she really was very close to the character she was playing.
Okay. And how about Will Gear?
He was exactly like he is on the show.
Yes, very grandfatherly then.
Good-natured. I knew Will for years before the Waltons. Because he was very much a theorist. And Will was like Johnny Appleseed. He would plant a garden wherever he worked. And he planted the garden on the Walton outdoor set.
Amazing, yes.
Well, that was his garden. That really was his garden.
I see. So he was a farmer in a lot of ways.
Certainly, yes. He loved to put his hands in the soil, that's for sure.
I see.
And, he was a real hippie.
Exactly, yes. And what was the atmosphere on the Waltons after Ellen got her stroke and Grandpa passed away?
Well, we were all very sad when Will died. We were on hiatus when he died, which in a way was hard because we all had to grieve separately, you know. But we did do a show that was in honor of his death, and I think those tears were pretty real.
Yes.
And Ellen, when she had her stroke, she was so wonderfully feisty and so with such a great sense of humor.
Mm-hmm.
It's funny because she could play the piano and she could sing Let Me Call You Sweet.
Yes.
But she couldn't talk.
Yes,
she could say no and yes. And if you wrote something out for her and held up a sign, she could say her line with a lot of difficulty, but she could do it. But even without speaking, she was still, don't you think she was just terrific?
Exactly.
I mean, I think she was amazing.
And she had a lot of body language to that character.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. And I adored her. We were very good friends.
Were you?
Very well.
I see.
I was near the end of her life, and Earl and I interred her ashes together.
Yes.
At the Hollywood Seminary and Cemetery, and we were very close.
I see. Okay. And where was the Waltons filmed? I understand it was based out of Virginia. But where was it filmed?
Well, the outdoor scene of the house and the swing and the barn, those were all shot on the Warner Brothers set in Burbank.
Okay.
It was called the Burbank Studios back then, but it's now called Warner Brothers.
Yes.
And it's gone now. The whole back lot is a parking lot, I think. It's all gone.
Oh, is that
so,
right?
That makes me kind of sad.
Yes, for
and,
sure.
And the interiors were also shot in that studio, Studio 26, I think it was.
Yes.
And it was kind of comforting. There were days when I was sort of going through turmoil in my own life, and I'd be waiting for my next scene, and Grandma and Grandpa would be having a scene, and I'd be sitting in the living room waiting for my scene to come up, and I'd start knitting, and there'd be a fire going in the fireplace. I thought, I just want to move in here.
Exactly. Yes. Now, your character, Olivia, I also understand, left the show halfway through.
Well, not halfway through. I left it at 8 years, and I think it went on another two seasons after.
Two seasons,
I got tired of, you know, there wasn't much left. They really racked their brains to try to give this middle-aged, they even had me go through the change of life. And,
oh, yes.
You know, they really tried to give me material to act, but it was getting to the point where I'd spend a long day just saying, more coffee, John, and time for bed, kids, and where have you been, and, you know, that kind of thing. And as an actress, I found that very
hard
because I like to act.
Exactly.
So, frankly, I was bored.
Yes.
And I did leave, and I missed everybody very much, and then I did a series called Nurse.
Yes, of course.
Which unfortunately was canceled, but that also was more appealing to me because I got to work in New York, which is really where I feel.
Oh.
I'm at home. And that was interesting and fun to do. Unfortunately, it got canceled. I put somebody off. I don't know who that somebody.
Yes.
So,
And were you ever typecast from the Waltons? This is going to be the last question about the Waltons for right now. But were you ever typecast?
Of course. I played a lot of nuns.
Yes.
And nurse.
Mm-hmm.
I was cast as nurse. And I think it's pretty normal.
Okay.
But not now so much, because I've done a lot of theater, and I actually have a show coming up in which I'm a totally different.
Yes, exactly. Person. So, yeah. Would you tell us about what you're doing nowadays? I know you have that new show coming on.
Yes, I do, which is unnamed, and I'm not allowed to talk about it, really, but it's for Ryan Murphy, and I was really honored to be, I really respect him as a producer, so I was honored to be cast in one of his shows. It was it's a series, actually. It's a 10-segment series, and I was in about 4 or 5 of them. So
okay.
It was very nice.
Okay.
Very nice. Yes. And I'm coming to Canada.
Oh, are you? Yes.
I'm coming to Petrolia in Ontario to do Ungolden Pond for the Petrolia Playhouse. I've worked with them several times before. A long time, many times. I love working up there, and I love these guys, David Hogan and David Rogers.
Amazing.
I'm looking forward to that.
Yes. Well, I'll hopefully be able to meet you if I'm up that way.
Well, I know. Okay.
Yes.
I hope you do.
Yeah.
Come back and say hello. We always meet the actors after the show. I mean, we always meet the public after the show.
Yes.
In that theater, which I like. We get a chance to really connect with people.
Exactly.
On a one-to-one level. I like that.
Yeah.
Have you ever been up there to the Petrolia Playhouse?
No, I haven't, but I've been up in that area before. It's not far from here, a couple hours from here.
They do an awful lot of musicals, and they started off in Sarnia.
Yes.
They're from Stratford, the two artistic directors are from Stratford.
Okay.
And my ex-husband Peter and I did a lot of work in Stratford.
Yes.
Many years ago, when the kids were little,
I see. Now, another classic role you have played, and this is going into your Broadway stuff, is Miss Daisy.
Oh, yeah, I love that show. I love that play.
Yes.
I could do that play over and over, and I never get tired of it. It's a wonderful, wonderful role.
Yes.
And I've been touring with that, and I did it off Broadway. And, I'd like to, I would really like to bring it to New York.
Okay, yes.
Broadway. I do it on Broadway. No, I did Gordy Dowd's Best Man and Pictures Road and Stripes on Broadway, but I've never done Broadway on Broadway.
Okay, okay.
That's a dream.
And so I must ask you a couple more questions if you have the time. This being the 50th year of the Waltons, of course, what has been the greatest achievement during those 50 years?
Staying alive.
Yes. Okay. And what do you think is responsible for longevity of the Waltons?
Well, it's a family show. I mean, I went to Bangladesh years ago, and they all knew who I was. I couldn't believe it. But it's a family show, so it resonates with anybody, positive or negative, who either had an unhappy childhood, and they get to relive their childhood in a happy way by watching the show. And happy childhoods identify with the Waltons as well. So I think it's a very all-encompassing kind of program.
Exactly. Yes, and it's a timeless program, that's for sure.
Yeah.
So, and with the last question for today, is with this airing on Mother's Day 2022, what would you like to tell your television children that grew up watching you?
Oh, I'm used to giving advice to the parents, not the children.
Yes.
You are somebody. You are somebody. Okay. Be who you are. I guess that's what I'd say. Be who you are. The greatest thing I think I learned from my kids was how to listen.
Yes.
But I had to listen to them. And if they were unhappy or if they were being really horrible, I still had to listen to them. And they had to know that they were hurt.
Yes.
And I have 3 wonderful grown sons now and grandchildren. And my life has been a turmoil when I was young, but it's a great old age. Golden years have been pretty good.
Well, that's great. That's great. And I want to say something on our farewell for today. And I hope to do it again sometime in the future with you as well. But that is good night, Mama.
Good night. Good night, everybody.
God bless you. You have a good day.
Thank you. Thank you so much. It was a nice interview. Thanks.
Thank you. God bless you. Bye bye.
Pretty quiet down now. Get some sleep.
Good night, everybody.
Good night, Mama. Good night, Ben.
Good night, everyone.
Good night, Mama.
Good night, Daddy.
Good night, children.
Good night, Daddy.
Good night, Elizabeth.
Good night, John Boy. Good night, Jim Bob. Good night, Jim Bob.
Good night, Jim Bob.
What's going on? I was asleep.
What's everybody doing?
Good night, Jim Bob.